Welcome to the Council of Better Business Bureaus podcast, Better Business, Better Series, where we will explore top-of-mind topics with business and industry leaders to understand the leading trends and innovations that continue to push the envelope in today's marketplace.
For the Better Business, Better Series podcast, I'm Will Johnson. Many of you might be heading to a wedding somewhere this summer, and some of you might even be walking down the aisle in one form or another. It goes without saying that weddings are big business in all the obvious ways and in some not so obvious ways. One aspect of getting married that is not super glamorous or sexy is the process of changing your name. This may come in the form of hyphenation or taking your spouse's last name. Whatever it is, you'll never know what a hassle it is until you actually go about doing it. But that's where Danielle Tate comes in. She runs a company that will actually take all the hassle out of the name change for you. And we have Danielle here with us today.
Thanks for having me.
The name of the company?
MissNowMrs.com.
MissNowMrs. It's really easy to remember and make sense. Let's start with talking about how you started thinking about this idea and turning it into a business. I'm guessing maybe you got married and that's what happened?
Yes. The story starts with love, which okay. I think, you know, all good stories start that
start.
Way. So fell in love, married this amazing man, and decided to change my name. I had this really long French last name and decided Tate was pretty straightforward, and took a whole day off work to change my name. Three individual trips later to the DC DMV to get my driver's license, I had accomplished nothing and was super frustrated with the entire name change process.
Okay. So firsthand, you realized that, and had you ever like even thought about this as a problem before? I mean, you knew you'd had to do it or you were going to do it.
Yeah, no, I'm super organized. I had my list of all of the different offices I was going to. I pre-filled in my paperwork. I'm not an unintelligent person.
Right.
And I stormed home. I'd like to say I was like, oh, this is terrible. No, I like came home and livid. I was the number one sales rep for a Fortune 500 company. So a day off work is a day not making money. And that's a pain point. And so I like stormed in our little condo and was like, why isn't there some sort of solution to name change? I'd pay anything to not do this. And my husband, being the yin to my uptight yang, was like, well, you should do that. And
that's cool.
That's how it started.
One thing I love about this is that it's like business that you start, and I think you told me earlier you're an accidental entrepreneur, but you truly are. You're realizing, okay, this is a problem, and all of a sudden, hey, maybe I can do something to fix this. It's just and it was a problem personally for you, which I think is where really great ideas can come from.
Exactly. Yeah, it was a personal pain point, and I did a little bit of research and found out that there's 2.3 million marriages in the U.S. every year, and 88% of those women decide to change their name and are therefore facing that same crazy red tape bureaucratic process.
And we can talk about changing times and the fact that some men are now taking their wives' last names, or there's hyphenation. There's all sorts of different things that are going on. No matter what you choose to do, somebody's got to go through this process. Right?
Somebody or both,
somebody's.
Both people, right? Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Let's talk specifically. You said you went three separate trips to the DMV, which sounds like anybody's idea of a nightmare. And for a lot of us who might not be so organized or have all the paperwork or whatever you need together, maybe more trips than three. So what are some of the reasons why changing a name is so hard? What can someone look forward to doing? There's lots of different things you might not think about.
Exactly. So every state has a different name change order and process. So there's the big federal agencies like Social Security, the Passport Agency, Postal Service, those people. But then on the state level,
yep.
Everyone's driver's license process is different. Some of them want to see your Social Security card in your maiden name. Some want to see it in your married name. Some want you to wait 2 days to 2 weeks after filing for your Social Security card just to come get your driver's license.
Was that part of your problem? Did you go too early?
No. First, I had brought the form that was on their website, but it was an outdated form. Then I brought my marriage certificate, but not my certified marriage certificate. Yeah. So there's all of these nuances.
I'd be so unhappy.
And some states take cash only for payment of fees.
Really?
I mean, I never have cash. So there's all of these barriers to getting it right the first, second, or third time. So in totality, it's about 13 hours to change your name.
And let me back up a step. So you came home, you talked to your husband. How soon after that conversation did you think to yourself, or after your experience, did you think about turning this into an actual business?
So he had that, you know, you should do it. And right. I had the immediate, well, no, I don't. I have a bachelor's
you
in biology. Like I was, you know, being very successful selling cancer diagnostic equipment.
Yeah.
But it rock tumbled. It wasn't like the movies. I didn't quit my job and immediately get, you know, venture funding and like start this huge company. I spent a couple months doing the research. Like, am I the person that made this difficult? Maybe just DC complicated name change, which is highly possible.
Right.
I called all 50 state DMVs and found out that it's not just here. Here's what you everywhere need. In all 50 states is incredibly difficult, and everyone's process is different. So,
and did you talk to friends, acquaintances, other people who were like, hey, what was your experience like?
Yes, and I sort of pioneered getting married. I was like on the earlier side of my friend set. But yeah, I literally, you know, talked to everyone I knew that was getting married or had just been married, and then started, you know, moving outward from there.
So you established that, okay, hey, maybe there's enough of demand. I mean, our podcast here is talking to business owners and people who are in business.
So that's
part of the process of like, okay, there's something needs to be done.
It's a niche market.
Yeah.
It's a pain point. It's a pain point people are willing to pay something for. And it's a renewable market. Every year, there's 2.3 million more customers.
That's amazing. So your business comes into play. Tell us how it works, why it's been so successful. You've done well. You started, what year was it when you first launched?
07.
Okay, so a while now.
Yeah.
And you've been doing this all along.
Yeah.
That's really cool. So this is not part of getting married that people really look forward to or even know much about. So I guess part of your challenge, I want to hear what you guys actually do to make it easy, is to get the word out there. Hey, this is something that can help.
Sure. So how we help is we're very similar to an online tax preparation service. So MissNowMrs is very much like TurboTax for name change.
Right.
So we ask the person who's changing their name, what's your name now? What's your new name? Your address? And then based on that information, the system starts pulling all the appropriate documentation, and we'll ask a few more form-specific questions. You then have two options. If you have our standard package, you click print,
yep,
and all of your forms print out.
Holy cow.
Completely, you know, filled in with all of the necessary information. My favorite part is they come with instructions written by me, not a team of lawyers. So it's sign here, date here. Here's a bulleted list of everything you need to bring. If you want to file in person, here's the day of the week and the time of day with the shortest lines. Like all of that inside scoop, mm-hmm, and then the prompts to get to a human being at that office if you want to call them.
So then you print all that out. And so what takes 13 hours takes
30 minutes.
30 minutes. I mean, who doesn't want this?
For a grand total of $30.
Right. And you told me that before we met up today, which is, I mean, you know.
And another iteration,
it's a great price point,
is the premium package where for $60, we will actually print the forms for you, put them in the appropriate envelopes with postage and the addresses. So all you have to do is sign and send
them.
Okay.
All right. So if you do the one for $30, you do the mailing. You print stuff out and then you
put the stamps on.
Right.
Exactly. But we tell you where they go.
I know so many people who would love, were they getting married again or for the first time? I mean, it just makes a lot of sense.
And I have an app coming out in July, which makes it even easier. You'll end up taking a photo of your license, your spouse's license. We scrape the data and mail the forms to you.
So there's a lot of back end IT stuff going on.
Then yes.
You've work with others.
Iterated.
That wasn't your expertise.
No, I did buy HTML for Dummies. I did a lot of the grunt initial coding, but no, database development was done by a technical co-founder.
I have a third package you can do, a dating site to find people, a spouse, and then you can get, anyway, sorry.
Oh, you had asked also, like, how do we market
to
people?
Absolutely, thank you for reminding me.
So it's very hard for me to compete dollar-wise with things that are beautiful and expensive, like dresses and cakes and flowers. Like, those are beautiful things that you want to click on and learn more and buy. Yeah, you don't want
to
hear about name change. You don't want
to
know about this problem. It's terrible.
Yeah.
So we ended up, strategic partnerships have been very key for us, especially at the beginning of the company. But a couple years ago, I realized, you know, we just can't compete ad dollar-wise. Like, what can we do? How can we educate and slightly entertain people so they know there's a problem and a solution? So we built marriednamegame.com. And it's this 8-question quiz. There's a patent pending on the algorithm because it's scary accurate. But basically, we use key life indicators from our 400,000 customers to pinpoint a couple questions about the bride's life and her personal style. And then this little dial spins around and gives her ultimate married name change option. And if she's in between two, the two that are most likely, and also layers in if her state allows that form of name change.
So it's a way of taking out the work of, it makes it kind of fun.
And it makes it fun. Right. It lets people realize there's like 6 different name change options available. It's a way to start talking about it and understand the process. And then of course, at the end, we're like, you know, when you're ready, there's this great service that's going to save you a ton of time.
All right. So as we discuss an accidental entrepreneur, you experienced this problem yourself. You said this is an issue, and you researched it and got into it. Tell us about some of the lessons you've learned along the way. You've been doing this for a while, and maybe what would have made your journey smoother if you had only known sooner.
Yeah, I learned endless lessons, usually the hard way. Yeah. I self-educated. I read a lot of books. I actually ended up writing a book for accidental entrepreneurs, sort of outlining these 12 steps to go from idea to scaling past the $1 million mark. But I think one of the most important big owies that I learned from was the importance of terms of use for your website or for your product, whatever someone's using.
So the literally like the check boxes, like terms and conditions?
Yes, okay. And making sure that they are attuned to your business. And that the key thing for you listeners is make sure that there's a clause in there about users not being able to create derivative works, which basically means they're going to use your service or your product or whatever you do
copycats.
The way it's supposed to be intended, but they're not going to be able to take valuable information and create something just like what you have. I say that because I have been through multiple lawsuits for copycats that came and scraped a great deal of data. And I think one of the lowest points of my entrepreneurial career was being 8 months pregnant, testifying in federal court.
Wow.
I was scared for my baby, my unborn baby, for the amount of stress that I was under. I was also scared for my first baby, my company.
Yeah.
And if I had slightly better terms of use, I wouldn't have been in that situation. And also a thing I learned, after lawsuit number 5 was think about like the special sauce. Like what's the thing that's most important or critical to your business?
Right.
And how can you safeguard it? So now if somebody changes more than 3 or 4 states, their account freezes and they get a pop-up that's like, hey, you might be confused. Give us a buzz. And, you know, we can talk about it.
Because that means that somebody's trying to maybe scrape.
They're mining all of the forms and data. If it's a military bride or somebody who has, you know, been all over, of course we unlock their account. But if it's somebody coming in with nefarious like ideas of, oh, maybe I'll just borrow all of this, they go away.
Let me see if I just get it straight. These are people that are coming in, nefarious individuals coming in and in one way or another taking your back end technology, the way it's
all of the forms
laid
the
out,
entire automation
and,
system,
and
all of our
giving
instructions.
Giving it another name and calling it their business?
Yes. And they stole my startup story that they didn't know how to change their name, but their wife and them had used the service multiple times.
Using your name?
Using their own name.
Using their own name.
Yeah.
And then changing the name of the company.
Correct.
And this happened 5 separate times, or were they different deals?
They were 5 different individuals that thought that would be really fun.
All right, so not to to linger there for too long, but it's a really important point you make is that a lot of folks go into business in one way or another, and they have a special set of skills or knowledge, but the legal end of things or the IT, and lots of times we just don't know. We don't have that skill set. So I would imagine reaching out to a good lawyer.
A good business lawyer.
Yeah.
And my gift to you, if you're in like startup world and scrappy the way I was, if you're bootstrapping, go to MissNowMrs.com, copy paste our terms of use and tweak it for your website. That's a band-aid. Don't keep it forever.
Right.
But if it covers you when you just get out the door until you start making enough money to talk to a business lawyer, please take it.
Oh, that's very nice of you.
I've paid,
so you got
I paid plenty
where,
for it.
Okay. Oh, wow. That's very generous of you.
Absolutely.
So hopefully no more lawsuits.
Knock on wood.
I mean, that's not a fun part of business for anyone.
No,
you
but if
focus
by
on
sharing
making,
it,
right.
other people can avoid it,
yeah.
that I'm happy to do so.
Just to highlight that, I mean, we get into business to, you know, share something we're passionate about, to bring, you know, maybe joy or
help
ease
people.
Or help to want, yeah, whatever you're doing and that aspect of it that is not so fun, you got to just keep in mind, it's going to rear its ugly head.
Yeah, I was this nice Methodist girl from Pennsylvania. It's like, oh, you build a business, you make a profit, you
nice.
Help people,
yeah, yeah.
like people do their own thing. And I was sadly a little bit mistaken on that front. I still have great faith in humanity, just
good.
Also in terms of use.
A related question, if you could give advice to your younger self getting started in business, maybe outside of all the legal stuff we're talking about there, anything in particular? It sounds like you kind of you were organized, you were passionate about what you were thinking and doing.
You know, one of my favorite quotes is, "She who dares wins."
Mm-hmm.
And so I think I would have told my younger self to dare a little bit more. It took one of those first lawsuits to scare me into locking up the big partnerships. Like I wanted to be like, oh, well, we need to have X number of customers and this revenue before I approach the big partners. And that wasn't the case. So, you know, daring to take the big steps and daring to do things sooner than you think you're ready is a recipe for success and adventure.
That's interesting because you want to be prepared enough to go talk to people, but on the other hand, don't spend all your time preparing and getting the logo and everything. I mean, that matters.
It doesn't have to, you know, it doesn't have to be perfect.
Yeah.
Like I'd rather be doing than have delayed perfection.
That's a really Good point.
And I didn't learn that until many years later.
So do you end up, as far as the marketing goes and getting the word out there, go to like wedding shows and things like that? Or is that not necessarily where you meet and pass
the word along? We started at the very beginning. We did do some bridal shows. And that's how we met
bridal shows,
and connected with many of our now large partners.
Okay.
But because of the low dollar value of my service, to go to those shows, to spend days at those shows, to be so far at the end of the wedding process, we break even, but it wasn't really worth the time and investment. We do a few shows that are for industry professionals, specifically wedding planners, because they can gift our service.
Okay.
So there's gift cards for Miss Now Misses. You can give them to friends. You can pick them up at Target, that sort of a thing. So helping them understand that there's a problem and a very readily available solution has been a really, really good thing for business.
Real quickly, names that are combined last names. You must get asked about that a lot. You must hear some good ones.
Blended last name?
Yeah, sorry, blended.
Blended or hyphenated? Where are
blended.
You?
I want
to,
yeah.
When you take the two last names and mush
them
together.
That's happening more and more, right?
It is. California currently is the only state that allows that through the married name change process.
Oh, really?
You need to know, heads up, Californians, that's the name you need to write on your marriage license application, because that will pull through to your marriage certificate. If it's on the marriage certificate, you can file all of your paperwork. Everyone else is going to need to go through the legal name change process,
right,
which is petitioning the court system, getting fingerprinted, a little bit more lengthy.
So you can do it, it's just a lot harder.
Exactly.
All right, well, and I'm sure you can learn more on your website, and we can't go through every state, but learn more at MissNowMrs.com.
Exactly.
And you have a sister site, is that what we call it, for people whose marriages did not work out and they're maybe getting divorced or something like that, to go back to their first name?
Yes, we have getyournameback.com.
Okay.
And a great story around that was my husband came in from a business trip, and I was sitting on the couch with a glass of wine and Divorce for Dummies propped open in my lap. He's like, do we need to talk? I'm like, yes, but not about what you're thinking. So we do take care of that process as well.
Thank you very much for talking to us today about your journey, your experience, and best of luck to you.
Thank you.
Thanks to Danielle Tate, founder of Miss Now Misses. If you'd like to learn more about the BBB, visit us at bbb.org. For the Better Business, Better Series podcast, I'm Will Johnson.
You just enjoyed Better Business, Better Series podcast. Be sure to tune in next month for a brand new episode. To learn more about our other shows, visit betterbusiness.blueberry.com. That's betterbusiness.blueberry.com and subscribe. The thoughts and opinions expressed on this podcast are the views and opinions of the guests, not those of the Better Business Bureau, Council of Better Business Bureaus, or program affiliates. This podcast is for information and educational purposes only and is copyrighted with all rights reserved. This podcast is protected by Blueberry's Terms of Service.